Hello. Let me welcome you again to a new series of Ask the Family Where. As you may remember, we test not only the memories of our contestants, but more importantly, their wits. First of all, let me introduce the Carter family, who come from Brighton. Mrs. Elaine Carter is a school welfare assistant.
Good evening.
Mr. Christopher Carter is a police sergeant.
Good evening.
And their children are Richard, 16, and Andrew, who's 13.
Hello. Hello.
And their opponents are the Leavey family from Marlow in Buckinghamshire. Mrs. Janet Leavey is a school teacher.
Good evening.
And Mr. Dennis Leavey is an electronic engineer.
Good evening.
And their children are John, 15, and Sarah, 13.
Hello.
Hello.
Let me remind you, and myself as well, I think, since it's the first programme, that the really only rule that counts is if you press that buzzer or press that bell, you have to answer immediately. Otherwise, a fine is exacted. Let's get off with some fairly simple questions. Only 5 points for these. We begin with a round of words beginning with the letters L-E-G. I told you it was easy. I think it is. A bequest?
Legacy.
Is a legacy. A sort of traditional story could be called a...
Legend.
A legend, indeed, yes. To make laws is to...
Legislate.
It is. I think the Carters know the answer, but they're not working their buzzers. But they'll get used to it quite as quickly. Ah, this might stop you. Type of straw hat. Perhaps it's well known to those who are well up in straw hats. I'm going to have to tell you, I don't know that you're going to get it. Leghorn. Apparently, well-known straw hat, leghorn. Anyway, here's an easy one to end with. A body of Roman infantry. Yes, it's the Carters.
A legion.
Yeah, you've got one at last. I am relieved. You've broken your duck. Now, we're all breathing freely after that little trot around. Have a look at this. You take the initial letter of the five birds you can see here, and then you manufacture from that those initial letters another bird. Which one? Ah, the Carters.
Heron.
Not heron. Now, the Leaveys can relax just a little. Well, I think I've given you quite long enough, have I? Yes, you shake your head. Robin is the answer. And I'll tell you why. There you see the name. Well, I don't have to. You see the names. Raven, owl, blackbird, ibis and nightingale. So you get Robin from that. Now we have a little music for you. Here he comes.
Here, rubber duck just sodbuster. Come on, hurry up. 10-4 sodbuster. Listen, you want to put that microbus in behind that suicide jockey? Yeah, he's hauling dynamite. He needs all the help he can get.
Well, we laid a strip for the Jersey Shore and prepared to cross the line. I could see the bridge was lined with bears, but it didn't have a doggone dime. I says, Pigpen, this here's a rubber duck. We just ain't gonna pay no toll. So we crashed the gate doing 98. I says, let them truckers roll 10-4.
Cross the almighty cowboy, rockin' through the night. Yeah, we got a mighty cowboy, ain't she a beautiful sight?
Well, there you had the peculiar argo of the CB radio, Citizens Band Radio. What I want you to tell me is in what month was it legalised?
November.
November's right. You might have taken a professional interest in it, Mr. Carter. Perhaps it was an unfairly loaded question in your favour. I suspect not. But yes, it was November 1981. Quite right. Here we have a list of four philosophers. Can you place them in the chronological order in which they lived? You have to know all four and avoid any hesitation. That's the thing.
C-D-A-B.
Let me just say that again. You said
C-D-A-B.
It so quickly.
C-D-A-B.
No.
Yes, C-A-D-B.
C-A-D-B is the answer. That's to say, Francis Bacon first, Immanuel Kant, Friedrich Nietzsche, and Jean-Paul Sartre. There you have it, and you have their dates. Can you tell me how the chemical elements mercury and bromine differ from all the other elements?
Liquid.
Yes, that's right. They are the only two elements that are liquids in their normal state, it says here. What relation is my father's brother's daughter to my son? Aha, rather like that. What relation is my father's brother's daughter to my son?
Aunt.
No.
Cousins.
Second cousin is the answer, and we have to have it precisely, because that's the way I got it wrong first. I thought it was cousin because I thought I was talking about me in the story, but it's my son. So it's a second cousin. Now, Can you tell me what would be the main ingredient I might need if I was preparing coquille Saint-Jacques for dinner? An unlikely contingency, I may tell you.
Chicken.
Not chicken. You mean you haven't recently prepared coquille Saint-Jacques?
Veal.
And not veal, but scallops. Scallops. Actually, in my experience in restaurant, the main ingredient is a lot of reconstituted mashed potato. How many months in the year have 31 days?
Seven.
Seven is correct. January, March, May, July, August, October and December. In this country, why was the 15th of February 1971 known, at least to incorrigible slogan mongers, as D-Day?
New decimal coinage.
Yes, that's right. The new decimal coinage came in. This question now is for father and elder child only. Who can say the name of the choreographer for the dance group Zoo on BBC Television's Top of the Pops?
Flick Colby.
Flick Colby is the right answer. Well done. Now a picture which emerges in fragments. How quickly will you be able to give me its title and the name of the painter? Already? No, that was an accidental buzz, was it?
Yeah.
Yes. I believe you. Because I'm sure you couldn't have told then. Now it's a real buzz.
Sunflowers by Van Gogh.
Yes, it is that. You didn't perhaps need to see very much of it, and now you see all of it in all its radiant glory. Here is some more music now. That was one of the six Haydn string quartets, but I want to know this. Who composed it? Yes.
Mozart.
Mozart, yes. It couldn't really have been anyone else. It was certainly Mozart. He dedicated the six quartets to Haydn, so they're Haydn quartets in that sense, but not in any other. Now, for this question, the word golden is particularly relevant. Oh, this series of questions, I should say. Beginning with, to where, according to James Elroy Flecker, did the Golden Road lead? Where did that lead to?
Samarkand.
It did. Who composed the opera The Golden Cockerel? Do you know? Is it even worthwhile making a guess? Perhaps not. It was Rimsky-Korsakov. Which African country used to be known as the Gold Coast?
Ghana.
Yes, Mr. Carter, you're right. It was Ghana. What is the chemical sign for gold?
AU.
It is. Who sang the theme song in the film Goldfinger?
Shirley Bassey.
Yes, she did. The Carters got that one. Well done. And the scores are now 55 to the Carters, 85 to the Leaveys. Have a look at these illustrations. Now the question is this. Which one of these planes fought in the First World War? Hello.
The Sopwith Camel.
Yes, the Sopwith Camel did. Ah, it comes as he beckons it. How splendid. Well done, Eric. That is the Sopwith Camel. And the others, oh, I should just say that you can read them there. The Bristol Bulldog was used in the 20s. The Gloucester Gladiator and the Fairy Swordfish were both used in World War II. Now, this Mrs. Smith used to get 2 pints of milk a day until it went up by a penny. She then cancelled Tuesday's and Thursday's order. If her weekly bill at the new price was £2, what was the old price of a pint? I'll keep nattering on about it while you work it out. She used to get 2 pints of milk a day until it went up by a penny. Then,
it used to be 19 pence.
Right, sir. You saved me reading through that dreadful problem yet again. But you got it absolutely right. 19 pence. Here's a question for children only. What do we call a chemical which is used to speed up a reaction but undergoes no permanent change itself?
Catalyst.
Yes, a catalyst is the answer. Here's an anagram. I wonder if you're any good at them. Here it comes. And I should say, by way of a clue, and an Italian gentleman too. And a Jewish one. And they were all engaged in trade. Now, the Leaveys.
The Merchant of Venice.
Yes, sir. It is the Merchant of Venice. Venice, it'll rearrange itself into that very title. Right enough. Would you care to listen to this piece of music now?
Come taste the wine. Come hear the band. Come blow that horn. Start celebrating. Right this way, your table's waiting. What good's permitting some prophet of doom to wipe every smile away? Life is a cabaret, oh chum. So come to the cabaret.
Right, on which book was that musical based?
I Am a Camera.
Not I Am a Camera.
Something like Nights in Berlin.
Not Nights in Berlin. Neither party were too far from it, because Christopher Isherwood wrote a book on which I Am a Camera, the film, was based. And Knights of Berlin comes close to the real title, which is Goodbye to Berlin by Christopher Isherwood. Who is known as the father of medicine? The Leaveys?
Is it Hippocrates?
So just say again what you said.
Hippocrates.
I put the emphasis on one of the other syllables, but Hippocrates, I would have said. but you said Hippocrates. I'm sure you knew who you're talking about. Hippocrates is the answer, or Hippocrates, if you like to say it that way. Yes, he's the father of medicine. 85 to the Carters, 105 to the Leaveys. Have a look at this, and tell me in what year these pictures made news. Yes, the Leaveys.
1978.
Yes, 1978 is right. Well done. Very quick. I'll say a little more about the pictures in case you haven't recognised them. Top left, you've got Close Encounters of the Third Kind, which had its royal performance in that year. Golda Meir died. Argentina won the World Cup. And Prince Michael of Kent was married. Now then, who, according to Tolkien, was actually the Lord of the Rings? You can't be members of that faithless band who didn't actually read it. Because if so, join me.
Gollum.
Yes.
Gollum.
No, not Gollum. Now, that is a name I do know out of it. I wonder if the Leaveys have the slightest idea. I don't think they have. They don't. They're looking dubious.
It isn't Frodo, is it?
It's not Frodo. It's Sauron, who apparently was the Dark Lord of Mordor. In which war was it that General Israel Putnam allegedly said, "Don't one of you fire until you see the whites of their eyes"? Yes?
The Zulu Wars.
Not the Zulu Wars, Mr. Carter.
The American War of Independence.
Yes, sir. You've got it right. A bullseye. Now, will you have a look at this? And I'll ask you a few questions. Now, you see how it's worked out at the top. Subdued, synonym for it would be cowed. You have to fill in words on the right-hand side. Similarly, with planted, valued, diced, and misled. I'll tell you this, it's a three-letter name of an animal in each case, a different one, I should add, that is missing. All four, of course, one after the other, trippingly. We just completed that top one to give you an idea. Tell you what, I'll take three out of four. How's that for a sportsman? Yes, the Carters.
The first one is sow, sowed. The second one is rat, rated. The third one is cub, cubed.
Yes, you just were within your time span there, Mr. Carter. I think you were just speaking slowly rather than really hesitating. And so you got those three, and there I show you the fourth, foxed. Misled is foxed. Rather good, but not as easy as all that. If 101 equals 5, what is 1,011 equal to? The young will be able to assist us.
11.
Yeah, you might say a word or two on that.
It's in binary numbers.
It's binary numbers, the binary scale. The new maths, as I believe it's called. Yes, indeed. Question now for the mother and younger child only. If there is a flock of 20 sheep going to market, how many legs of mutton will there be? Aha.
40.
40's correct. Would you like to say why, Mrs. Leavey?
Is it just rear legs?
It's just the rear legs, you're quite right. The front legs are the shoulders, and so 40 is right. Can you identify the subject of this photograph, one of those photographs taken from a peculiar angle? Yes.
A torch.
Not a torch. Can the Carters do it?
A pump.
Yes, it's a pump. It looked for all the world like a spaceship to me. But it's a pump, as you could clearly see. Once you got it into focus, there it is. Now, I've got some quotations, and each of these three quotations has been made by someone called Smith. You have to say which Smith. First one. The world continues to offer glittering prizes to those who have stout hearts and sharp swords. Which Smith uttered that rather greedy-sounding rally to arms?
He became Lord Birkenhead. That's which Smith he was.
Now, that's perfectly... and that's identification enough for me. Mr. Leavey, I mean, there can't be too many Smiths who became Lord Birkenhead. This was one, Earl of Birkenhead. He was F.E. Smith, you know. And then, here comes another Smith. I was much too far out all my life, and not waving, but drowning. Which Smith said that?
Stevie Smith.
Stevie Smith, that's the only one you'd ever heard of. Well, I think, honestly, it's about the only one there was, perhaps. But yes, she wrote that. Finally, as the French say, there are three sexes, men, women and clergymen. Who said that? Which Smith said that? Then I must tell you if you don't know. That was the Reverend Sidney Smith, the great wag and wit. And so we proceed to more music now. Can you tell me then, in celebration of which river did the composer Smetana compose that patriotic piece of music?
Danube.
No. Do the Carters know?
The Rhine.
No, it is the Vltava River. Now the scores, Carters have 105, Leavey's have 165. Here is a picture, it's a photograph. You have to tell me which poet's boyhood home this was. He once wrote to his mother that if he could obtain the first fortune in the country for it, he'd reject the proposition, but eventually he was forced to sell this great house to pay his debts. Went abroad, didn't come back. Who was he?
Lord Byron.
You're right, sir, Lord Byron, and that's a photograph of Newstead Abbey, which is near Nottingham. There it is again. In the parable of the Good Samaritan, where was the man travelling to when he fell among thieves?
From Jerusalem to Jericho.
He was travelling to Jericho, yes. If two dice are thrown, what is the numerical probability of a total score of 5?
1/9.
1 in 9, yes, 1/9, that's a way of putting it. 1 out of 9, anyway. Now, have a look here. I wonder what these names have in common, do you know?
Card games.
They are, sir. That is just what they... Was that plucked out of the dark blue yonder?
Yes. I must admit.
Inspiration. You just let your imagination free. Yes, they're games of patience, as a matter of fact. Card games. Question for fathers only. How could you tell the difference between an unlabeled bottle of Mosel and an unlabeled bottle of Hock without drinking it or even smelling it?
The Hock is in a long, thin bottle, and the Moselle's in a bottle with a much a more definite neck?
No, that isn't the answer to the question.
The Hock is in a green bottle and Moselle in a brown.
Oh, dear. What a pity. It's exactly the other way round. Oh, dear. Makes me feel satanic that I can't give you a mark for that, but I'm sure I can't, otherwise the Carters had said about me. No, the Moselle is in the green bottle and the Hock is in the brown. Bad luck, Mr. Leavey. My heart goes out to you. Have a look at this. There's something pretty wrong with this book. Can you say what it is?
It's written by Charlotte Bronte.
No. There's nothing descend or enlightenment not come to you. I'm obliged to tell you that it's not by Emily Bronte, it is by Anne Bronte. Near miss for the Carters, but, you know, there Eric shows you now. Is the Jewish festival of Yom Kippur to celebrate Atonement, Thanksgiving, or the Jewish New Year?
It's the Day of Atonement.
It is. Atonement. Now, this picture you may already have seen in last year's newspapers, but you have to say what it's of. What is the event? Yes.
It's the Iraqi hostages returned to Washington.
Yes. I don't think I'll penalise you for saying Iraqi when you mean Iranian, because it was clear you knew what you were talking about. Yes, the hostages, the American hostages being returned. Who can remember the price of the Mad Hatter's top hat?
2 and 6 pence.
No.
12 and 6 pence.
No. 10 and 6 pence. Neither 2 and 6 nor 12 and 6. 10 and 6 had it stuck in the side of it. A notorious partnership existed between Robert Leroy Parker and Harry Longbow. By what names were they better known?
Barnum and Bailey.
Not Barnum and Bailey.
Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid.
That's who they were. That notorious pair. Quite right. Which country was the first to give its women the vote?
Holland. Holland.
Not Holland. No, not Holland. They lagged behind.
America.
Nor yet America. It was New Zealand in 1893. What have Arthur Turner, George Cave and Lord Lambourne in common?
They're apples. All types of apples.
They are, sir. I've got another name down here, which I deliberately left out because I thought it was too easy. James Grieve. But you obviously know your apples, Mr. Carter. That's right, they're all apples. Now, the scores are 125 to the Carters, 225 to the Leaveys. Here is our last question. What do needles, potatoes and hurricanes have in common?
They all have eyes.
Right, young Carter. Yes, indeed, they all have eyes. That they do. And so let me show you, as you can see, 135 and 225. The Leaveys are the winners. The Carters fought them a very good fight, but I think they were just slower on that buzzer. But it's the Leaveys who will be coming back and to have another go later on. And this programme will be returning at the same time next week. Until then, goodbye.